Cavendish experiment. Newton's laws of gravitation state that every particle attracts every other particle in the universe with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their centers. If we want to write this as a formula, F will be equal to G into m1 into m2 upon r square, where F is a force, G is constant, m1 is the mass of the first object, m2 mass of the second object, r is the distance between the objects. Question asked was that the constant known as universal gravitational constant, how to find its value? In reality, there such a gravitational force observed between any two objects on the earth? And if so, how to find the value of G? Many experiments were carried out. In 1797 and 98, British scientist Henry Cavendish carried out some experiments. Such experiments were tried before as well. His experiments were the first to yield accurate value for the gravitational constant. The apparatus he used can be seen in this animation. He used a torsion balance or pendulum made of a wooden rod 6 feet or 1.8 meters horizontally suspended from a wire with 2 inch or 51 millimeters diameter, 1.61 pounds or 0.73 kilograms lead spheres each attached to each end. Two 12 inch or 348 pound lead balls were placed near the smaller balls about 9 inches away. They were held in place with a separate suspension system. The mutual attraction between the two large balls and the small balls caused the arms to rotate, twisting the wire supporting the arms. The arms stopped rotating when they reached an angle where the twisting force of the wire balanced the combined gravitational force of attraction between the large and small lead spheres. By measuring the angle of the rod and knowing the twisting force or torque of the wire for a given angle, the force between the pairs of masses could be determined. To measure angle of twist, reflection from a plane mirror attached to torsion wire was used. Cavendish measured the angle, and with the help of this angle, he could find the value of the gravitational constant given in your textbook as G equal to 6.67 into 10 raised to minus 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square.